So I'm Salek from Prismic, and I'm here with Wes Bos. Can you introduce a bit yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. So my name is Wes. I'm a full-stack JavaScript developer. Spend a lot of time in React and Node, and I create online courses and have a podcast all about web development.
Yeah, very, very good webcast. there's something that there are a lot of frameworks out there, React framework, so doing stuff on top of React.
Yep.
And they're becoming very popular. And they had, there's Next.js and there's Gatsby. And they kind of do things differently. They're both React frameworks, but they do them differently. Can you tell us a bit about this?
Yeah. So Next and Gatsby are sort of in the world of you want to build a React website or application, but you don't want to have to deal with routing or config or if you need server-side rendering, all this hard stuff that surrounds React they attempt to do. And they both accomplish that, but then they have their own way of going about it, which is what we're here to talk about today.
Right. So the first thing I want to understand is, like, imagine you're in front of your browser. We deployed both apps, one Next and the other in Gatsby.
Yeah.
And I hit the URL on the browser. What happens?
Yeah, so the main differentiator between the two is that Next.js is dynamically rendered, and Gatsby is statically generated and rendered beforehand. So let's talk about you go to /about on a website. What happens in that case? So in Next.js, what would happen is there's a Next.js server running, which runs a node that will accept the request, and it will say about, and then it will, from there, it'll say, okay, now we need to find a page called about, and it will go off and get that page. That page might go fetch some data from a database, wait for the data, come back with that data, render it out, and then send it out to the client. Whereas with Gatsby, so you hit /about, what happens is that since Gatsby is a static site generator, and I don't even think that's necessarily a good idea for it, because it sort of puts it in a category of all these sort of like dumb static site generators. So we'll talk about that. But
which is not, actually.
It's not. It's very full-featured, and it still is a React application. But the way that it works is that before you deploy your website, or as part of some deployment process, Gatsby's going to go ahead and make that page into a static HTML page. Beforehand, so it'll fetch the data at compile time, and then at the end of the day, you just have a folder called about and an index.html file in there that it will then immediately serve up for you. And then what happens is Gatsby picks it up from there and sort of rehydrates it, and then it becomes a React application.
A full React application.
Full React application, yeah.
So in one case, the request is happening, you're fetching data every time,
yep,
with Next.js, right? And you're grabbing the server and going back, whereas in Gatsby example, you're just hitting a static file.
Yeah, and we should say Next.js has an option to do static as well, to output.
Right.
But I think in most cases, if you're going for static, you probably should reach for Gatsby then.
Right, and there are a lot of different differences between these, how they handle things, like Next and Gatsby. Maybe let's start with data. How do they handle data?
Yeah, so Next.js is unopinionated about how you handle your data. Really, the only one thing that Next.js cares about is they have their own lifecycle method called getInitialProps, and that's an asynchronous method that needs to be resolved before the data can be sent from the server to the client. And that's how it knows to go off and fetch the data that's needed for that page. Like, let's say we're hitting a database to fulfill that. But it doesn't care you how you get that data. Whereas Gatsby, what it will do is they allow you to go off to any API that you want. It could be an API, it could be a markdown file. It's going to source your data from WordPress or markdown files or whatever it is that you want. And then it makes it available to you via a GraphQL API. And then when you're building out your pages, you write queries against that GraphQL API for a list of blog posts or the about page content. And in at render time, it makes that GraphQL API available to you, and then it will render out those HTML pages for you.
And that's maybe a very interesting thing in GraphQL, in Gatsby, that it wraps everything into GraphQL. So
yeah, it's really cool because it makes you, Gatsby is very much about, it needs to know about everything happening on your website, or all of your data, all of your images, all your style views, everything needs to go through Gatsby. And because everything's going through Gatsby, there's some cool stuff. We'll talk about plugins in just a second.
Right.
Some cool stuff that's really surfaced with that.
So there's also the routing that is very different between them. Can you tell us a bit about the differences between routing in Gatsby, if we can call it that, and in Next.js?
So the way Next.js works is that you have a folder called pages, and it's a throwback to when you just had HTML or maybe a PHP server where you had a folder, and inside of that folder you can create index.js, about.js. You can create a subfolder with pages inside of that, and that is your routing. So there's no writing to config. You simply just create pages inside the pages directory, and you're up and running. Gatsby does it that way as well, where you can have a pages directory, create all your pages in it. However, they also have an API where you can dynamically create routes. So we talked about the GraphQL API, where maybe you could query a list of blog posts, and then you loop through those blog posts and use the create page API to dynamically create the pages. And you can specify what the slug is, what component will be rendered out. And it's pretty cool because you can, if you have a list of 10,000 blog posts, you could just loop through those and dynamically create pages for each one.
Right. And also there is, so Gatsby, you talked about plugins, and there are a lot of plugins for Gatsby. Can you tell us about more about plugins? I don't know if Next.js has plugins.
Yeah, Next.js doesn't really have plugins because the scope of what Next.js is much smaller than the scope of something like Gatsby. So Gatsby is very much like WordPress in that it has this huge ecosystem of plugins, as well as coming soon is Gatsby themes as well. And I think that's really cool because the way that plugins work is they sort of sit in between the code that you write and the code that gets outputted. And like I said earlier, because everything goes through Gatsby, Gatsby able to sort of step in between there, and whether that's an image or some CSS that needs to be compiled or some JavaScript that needs to be minified or you name it, right? You have access to all of these things in between. So you can jump in and compress. Some of the really cool stuff I think in plugins is around image preloading. So one of the cool plugins will resize an image down to like 20 pixels by 20 pixels. So that'll load instantly via Base64. And then as it loads in the larger compressed file in the background, it will just fade to that larger file, which is really, really cool. That's something that would have taken a lot of work previously, and now it just comes for free with a Gatsby.
And that's what's interesting is that each time, there are these little things that make a difference, but they're very hard to implement.
Yeah,
it gives you out of the box, with plugins. You don't have to implement them, but you get these kind of little tricks that makes that website quality overall much better.
Mm-hmm. Right? I think that's why it's not fair to say Gatsby is a static site generator.
Yeah.
It's more of like a progressive website generator where it makes these new things in the browser very easy to do.
Right. Yeah, probably they need to rebrand in that case.
Yeah.
So what about the deployment? How do you deploy each Gatsby?
Gatsby, at the end of the day, it's compiled down to a bunch of CSS, HTML, and JavaScript. And as we know, you can deploy that anywhere you want, right? You don't even need a special config, because like a Nginx config or something like that to handle routes, because it literally makes folders called of every one of your blog posts and every one of your pages. So that's cool. You can host it pretty much anywhere you want. And Next.js is a node application, which you can host pretty much anywhere you want to host your regular DigitalOcean or Zite has their own nice hosting version as well.
And they're doing something very, lately, very interesting, is that the serverless.
Yes.
Next.js.
Yeah, they're taking their node hosting platform or anything hosting platform, and they release Now 2, which is going to be able to just host. It will take your node apps and take things like your Next.js applications and turn them into serverless applications. So if you've got a website that doesn't have a whole lot of traffic, it's unnecessary to be running
that machine, right?
Yeah. So if you can just quickly boot up that application when somebody visits, the first person, kind of like Heroku does right now,
right?
Where the first visit might be a little bit slow, but then after that, it'll be running for a little while before it decides to shut itself down.
Yeah, it's very interesting. We'll see how that goes. Yeah. Well, thank you very much. This is
thanks for having me.
Interesting. Cool.